This video, brought to you by Welyong Ni Tetro, will explain the gingerbread cookie. When you look around in this world, everyone seems to be a woman or a man. But what exactly does that mean, being a man or a woman? And what does it mean when people want to change their gender? Or when they dress like the opposite sex? And how about people that identify as neither male nor female? And when you are gay, does that change anything about your gender? To explain all of this, we need the help of the gingerbread cookie. Before we start, it's essential to explain the difference between your sex and your gender. Sex is biologically determined and has everything to do with what's inside of your pants. It is often assumed that everyone is born either male or female. But what a lot of people don't know is that biological sex lies on a spectrum. Everyone who is not 100% male or female is called intersex. Now, what exactly is intersexuality? Approximately 1 in 3,000 babies is born with ambiguous genitals, which for example could look like this. In this case, doctors often can't determine immediately whether the baby is a boy or a girl. There are also other ways in which a person can be considered intersex. For example, through a difference in the level of your chromosomes, your gonads, or your hormones. So, what does the passport of an intersex person look like? In Belgium, it is, up to now, only possible to be legally registered as an M or an F. This means that there is no possibility for intersex people to have their biological sex recognized by the state, so people often have to choose the sex of the baby at birth. In the entire world, only 7 countries and 5 American states have some sort of legal recognition for intersexuality, which is not a lot. We covered sex, but what about gender? Your gender or gender identity denotes how you feel. A person can feel exclusively feminine or ultra-masculine, but this too lies on a spectrum. It is perfectly possible to feel a little bit more masculine than feminine, or the other way around. Some people feel both male and female, or neither, and just want to be themselves. To define these gender identities, a lot of complicated names exist, such as these ones. Each of these words describes a slightly different gender identity. However, this is not written in stone, and only you can decide which word fits you the best. When one's sex and gender identity align, for example, when you are born female and you feel like a woman, we call this person cisgender. However, when one's sex and gender identity do not correspond, we call this person transgender. We do not, however, use the word transsexual. Originally, this word was used to describe trans people who had undergone gender confirmation surgery, but nowadays this is considered outdated and sometimes even hurtful. Besides, not everyone who is transgender wants to have a surgery, of course. The third aspect of our gender is comprised of how we present ourselves to the outside world and of how others perceive us. We call this our gender expression. Just like the other aspects, your expression can also be female or male, or something in between. A person's gender expression exists of many layers. The most obvious one is, of course, the clothing you wear. Do you wear manly clothes or feminine clothes? However, also your haircut, the way you talk, the way you move, walk, or sit, the hobbies or interests you have, the books you read, the music you listen to, the movie genres you like, and even the drinks you order on a night out are gendered. So, basically everything. Important to remember here is that what is considered masculine or feminine is incredibly time and location bound. These ideas are not the same everywhere and at all times. A funny example are high heels. While the Western world now sees them as typically feminine footwear, in the Middle Ages it was completely normal for men to wear shoes like these. Now, what exactly is meant with transvestism? A transvestite is someone who takes on the stereotypical gender expression of the opposite sex. Here, for example, you see Lady Gaga, who takes on a male gender expression. Or the world-famous drag queen RuPaul, who takes on a female gender expression. It doesn't all have to be so binary. When someone doesn't limit themselves to the categories of man or woman and just mixes it all together, we use the word androgyny. A widely known example of a person with an androgynous gender expression is David Bowie. The fourth aspect of your gender has to do with who you are sexually or romantically attracted to. We call this your attraction. You can feel attracted to men or women. A person who likes people from the opposite gender is called heterosexual. A person who likes people from the same gender is called homosexual. You can also, of course, like both genders, which is then called bisexuality. Once again, it doesn't have to be so black and white. Human sexuality is considered to be fluid, which means that it is changeable throughout time and depends on the situation. You can, for example, feel incredibly attracted to men, but also a tiny bit to women. Or it could happen that even though you felt attracted to women your entire life, all of a sudden you fall in love with a man. Some people also identify as pansexual. In this case, your attraction is not confined within the borders of the binary gender spectrum, and you actually feel attracted to a person's personality rather than their sex. Another sexuality which falls outside of the spectrum is asexuality. Asexual people do not feel sexual attraction to others at all. This, however, does not mean that they do not long for a romantic relationship or affection, just no sex. Even though you cannot choose your sexuality, identity and labels seem to be very important to define one's attraction. Labels like gay and straight exist because a lot of people find comfort in the idea of belonging to a group and use these words as tools for explaining their identity to others. These labels are, however, not clearly defined. Which labels you choose to describe yourself and how you define them is highly personal and can never be wrong. After all, nobody knows you better than yourself. Moreover, you are not obligated to give yourself a label at all. As you see, your gender is a lot more complicated than what they expect from you at birth. The genderbread cookie is not even complete. The construction of a person's gender is an incredibly complex process which involves psychology, biology, sociology, and so much more. Capturing this process in a small cookie would be very ambitious. But it's a start.